जब बारिश होती है सब इकट्ठा होता है इसके ऊपर, फिर इसके ऊपर मशरूम्स आते हैं और रुई निकली और उसके अंदर काली बीज निकली है।
My name is Himanshu Prem Joshi. All my life I have been campaigning to protect the environment in India. And I now arrange eco tours to nature parks and wild regions.
वो senses कहते हैं ना हम उसको, our five senses. You should always be alert and use those five senses when you are in the forest or whenever you are in nature. ये
बच्चे। Like most Indians, I am a Hindu. And traditionally, my religion reveres nature. I believe that faith can inspire us to protect the natural world.
सूखे पेड़ में रहता है। Everything is planned, you know. Everything has its infinity. And in fact, that is why it is there.
For me as a Hindu, the temple is a very holy place and I often come here to make my devotions. In Hinduism, we have many gods. One of the most popular is the elephant god Ganesha, who you will see in most temples.
Well, you see, the Hinduism or the Indian thought is totally related to nature and wildlife. And in the Hindu thought, you don't even know where nature ends and Hinduism begins. They are so fully well integrated with each other. And if you notice the gods, they always are connected with some or the other animal. So the monkey god Hanuman, who's the god of wind and strength. You'd also find the great god Vishnu reclining on the cobra. So almost all gods have something or the other in nature woven around them. It simply signifies that you protect and respect nature. You keep the ecological balance intact. That is exactly what it tells and expects of any person.
Many a time, I bring tour groups to the remoter regions of India. This is the semi-arid scrub jungle of Gir in western India. And even now in the dry season, it's a haven for nature and wildlife. These young people are from cities, and this is a rare chance for them to experience one of the few remaining wild areas of India.
Look at this. That is why most of the census and the surveys of animals are done during summer.
He stopped himself.
This magnificent animal is an Asiatic lion. It might look like its African cousin, but in fact, it's a distinct subspecies. This kind of lion was once found all across Asia, but human activities have now reduced it to this small pocket in this part of India, the last population of its kind in the world. I tend to use trips like this to spread the message of conservation. And the gir lions are a good example, a species that we humans have almost brought to extinction. And you have to ask, what right have we as human beings to decide the fate of any of the other species on this planet?
Sometimes when I see these things, I feel very sad that everything just keeps going away and there are hardly a handful of people who may be concerned. We want to see you, I mean, not only concerned, but if possible and wherever possible, you know, trying to make any little contribution. Our Vedas have taught us to give what you have. If you have strength, you give strength. If you have, wisdom, you give wisdom. If you have intelligence, you give that. If you are a journalist, try and find what's going wrong with the environment today.
Sir, I think just spreading the awareness on paper doesn't work.
Absolutely.
They have to actually come and see like how we are seeing. Then only they have some affection towards wildlife.
The
otherwise, reading articles,
they don't read so much.
Through example, yeah. You have to set an example.
Yeah, because when you come here, you start loving the place. You start loving the environment. You like the atmosphere. Freedom. And then you want, and then you see the stark difference between your urban, you know, dirty lifestyles, if I may call it.
Yeah, it is.
And see
and
this world.
Yeah,
and you see how important and how beautiful all this is.
As well as showing tourists around, I've also been campaigning about wildlife protection for many years. They've tried to persuade the local people to conserve the lions and other wild animals in this region. Already, many farmers like Ismail Bhai realize the importance of conserving wildlife, even though the lions occasionally kill their buffaloes and cows. So our modern ideas about the importance of conservation are completely in tune with traditional views.
ધર્મને કારણે
હા ધર્મને કારણે જોડાયેલ છે નરસિંહ ભગવાન રૂપ અવતાર ધારણ કરેલું છે સિંહમાં હરિનો વાસ છે એવું પણ લોકવાયકા બોલતા હતા પછી ઘણા રિચેસકારોએ એવા રિપોર્ટ આપેલા જૂનાગઢ નવાબને કે ભાઈ સિંહ રાખવા જરૂરી છે આ એશિયા ખંડમાં બીજે નથી એની પાછળ પણ એનું રક્ષણ થયેલું જ છે ને
ધ રિલિજન ક્લિયરલી પ્રીચેસ નોટ ટુ કિલ anything, not to kill animals, birds. In fact, Emperor Ashoka in the 2nd century BC, that is over 2000 years ago, said that they should not be killing wildlife, and some of the scriptures even exist till date. And in fact, our national emblem has lion in it. So everybody is aware that lion is an important animal.
While a reverence for nature still exists in parts of India, in cities like Mumbai, nature is taking a real battering. Mumbai is a mega city with mega environmental problems. The city has a population of about 16 million and spans over 30 kilometers across. We have the biggest slums in Asia and some of the worst air pollution anywhere.
Pollution is horrible, in fact. And if you knew the figures around 1947, 50 years ago, I would say vehicle load pollution in India was just 0.15 million tons in that year. But now, After 50 years, it's grown to over 11 million tons every year. So that's shocking. Garbage problem is a major problem here. All kind of waste is generated in very huge proportions. And people just tend to keep using and using things and then throwing metal and rubber and glass and plastics everywhere. I would say that population is probably the root cause of all the problems, because it's the problem of numbers and the resources. You can't really have just a little space and then millions of people are depending on it. What happens is that people keep increasing and their demands grow higher and higher, and then obviously there is very little place. It, you know, creates hypertension and stress on people. Hinduism is very, very relevant today, and the very fact that nature is depicted all over the religion meant that people worship nature. It was meant to be that way. You protect the ecological balance, you don't disturb what the universe has created. You are not meant to be disturbing this balance. Now we have totally messed up, and people have totally misinterpreted the religion, and it's really taking a toll. And yet, even in the worst of the slums, there is hope for a better environment. We Indians have a genius for recycling, and this is already helping to control the garbage problem in Mumbai. Another major success has been Mahim Nature Park, right in the middle of Mumbai's slums, with an environmental education center at its heart. I helped to create this park, which amazingly is built on a huge rubbish dump of city waste. We call this turning garbage into gold. We keep one small area unchanged to show visitors what lies just underneath the trees.
घूमते हैं तो ये देखिए पपाया का पेड़ है और क्या-क्या है जंगल में.
Inspiration for this park is rooted in our traditional, often religious attitudes to nature. And I believe that a rediscovery of these traditions can help to solve at least some of our major environmental problems, and so improve life for many millions of people in India.
Badami. So, when they are small, they are like this.